Hey guys, welcome to my first stretch video for the Hampton Health and Fitness Club. Hoping you're all keeping well, self-isolating, do what you gotta do, staying indoors. So I'm gonna take you through my first stretch and flex class today. We're gonna start with our head, work it down our body, and just make sure you've got enough room to not kick anything or anyone or pets in your house. So let's get cracking. Just gonna start off with our head, looking over one shoulder. And back to the centre, and the other side. And one more time, nice and relaxed, through the centre, over your first shoulder. Through the middle, and the other side. And start giving a nice little semicircle around the throat. Rolling your chin over your chest. And bringing it up. Think about dropping your chin down to your chest. If you want to intensify the stretch, just lace your fingers around behind your head and just add a little pressure, nothing too much. And release. Nose to the ceiling. And again, dropping your chin to your chest, intensifying it as you wish. And pulling it up. Nose to ceiling one last time. And back to the middle. Rolling it out again with those couple of semicircles just to keep loosening up these necks. And up. We're going to drop our ear over towards one shoulder. Arm around the top and just a gentle push, just a little bit of pressure on top of our temple. You should feel the stretching right down this side. Good. And swap it over to the other side. Palm round, little push. You just feel that intensify as you just add that a little bit of pressure. And release. Just gonna start. Make sure you've got a nice stance. Just leaning down towards one side. Bring it up. Try and keep your shoulders square as you stand up. And then down to the other side. You might find one side is just that a little bit more dexterous, that a little bit more mobile than the other. Absolutely fine. A couple more reaching over. And we go back to our first side. Bring your arm involved and think about not leaning forwards or rolling back. You want to keep flat as if you've been between two panes of glass. If you can, look up towards these top fingertips and you should feel this stretch right down this top side here. And up. And just swapping it over. Again, sliding down, don't be too concerned if you're here, if you're far down, wherever you are, it is not a competition. You're just giving your muscles a bit of a nice stretch out. Again, think about that eye line as well if you can. And bringing it up, lovely. This time, we're going to think about bending our arms, we can push our elbow into our hip. A little bit of a contrast in shape here. You should find by pushing the opposite way, you can get a little bit more of a reach over. Again, I'm keeping my eye line on this top hand. Good. And up to the top, at the top, just doing a couple of side leans, keeping nice and limber. Try not to move from your hips. You're keeping your hips stationary, so it's just your trunk.
and your upper body that's moving from your waistline. Elbow in, over to your side. Make sure you're holding these positions about 15 to 30 seconds. Good. This time at the top, gently pushing back with our shoulders. So I'll show you what I mean from the side. So I'm not pushing, arching, I'm keeping everything straight, and it's just my shoulders and my arms that are pushing back. Arms straight if you can, or bend with the elbows if you find that opens them up a little bit further. Once again, it's whatever works for you. Keeping those feet in your nice stance, go for a flat back position. So rather than keeping our body square, we're now going to be twisting and pushing over this foot here, trying to create a flat back position. You should feel this burning your arms after a little bit. You should feel this in this front leg and squeezing all those muscles as you hold it. Through the centre, again thinking about a nice flat back position, looking over your little fingers. Excellent, and onto the other side. Again, you should really feel this burning now. Your arms should be begging to come down. Keep holding that position. And drop towards your leg. We're just going to start gently pulling ourselves in with this just nice little bopping movement, as I call it. It's just bopping in and out, nice and gently. Feel that warm up right down the back of this leg. And hold at that bottom. Again, it really doesn't matter how far you're getting down. You might be holding higher, you might be holding lower, it doesn't matter. Wherever you can feel the stretch. And through the centre. Again, just think about trying to have your arms straight if you're not reaching down. Fingertips reach for the floor, absolutely fine. If you can, bend your elbows down so you're pushing it further if you find you're able. And we're going over to the other side. Again, those nice fluid movements. We're not trying to yank ourselves in. We're not doing anything sharp. It's just very relaxed within that range of your flexibility. And hold it at the bottom. Excellent. We're going back through the centre. This time, you think about pulling your arms through your legs. So even if you're just reaching through, that's fine. Whatever you find works for you best. Make sure if you need to, widen your stance. You might find actually if you widen it a little bit, you can get down to the floor, or it might just help your balance out. So just get where you get a comfortable position. And then pulling it up to the top, circling your arms around. These are going to your hips, the small of your back. So think about counterbalancing, pushing your bum forwards basically, as you think about arching back, opening up your stomach muscles, stretching your spine. Look to the ceiling, or if you feel able, you can look behind. Good, and let's do it again. So reaching forward, pulling ourselves through. So really feel this one down both behind your legs. And up we go. Nice circle at the top. Hands to your hips. Push and look. Good. Excellent. So bring these feet in. We're going to do a couple of circles with our knees. It's just the other backs of our legs are break. Think about arms out on your hips. If you need to balance, hold the side. It's your preference. You think about taking your knee out in a large circle. Couple more of those. And then we're going to think about going out in. So I find these a little bit trickier. Think about creating those large circles with your knee. Good. Going to go back into our nice stance. So for this one, actually the wider you go, the harder it is. So I kind of go just a bit uncomfortable, shoulder width, maybe just over shoulder width apart. Think about doing a sink squat. So you're going to sink right down, right, get your bum in line with your knees, but again, wherever you can get to, use your arms as you will. And at the top, we're pulling up onto our toes, stretching out our ankles, strengthening those tendons and ligaments. Again, if you do my class, you'll know balance is not particularly my forte, so I do apologise if I fall over, but don't feel you have to. If you can hold it longer than me, please go for it. Good, we'll hold this section at the top for 5. And up, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and down. Good work. Couple of shoulder circles around. Think about pulling your shoulders as high as you can towards your ears and dropping them as low as they'll go. Excellent. Fingertips to your shoulders, pulling your elbows together. Again, make the biggest circles you can. Think about pulling them together at the back. You won't be able to reach them, but you feel that pull between your shoulder blades, so you know it's working. And release. Full circles round. Breathe at the top, release at the bottom. Very nice, one more. Lovely. Right, let's have a go at some of our stretches where we're going to get down on the floor now.